This Phantom is Ready for High Tea. Published in January of 2022, Sylvia C. writes that she was quietly watching TV when her resident ghost startled up the tea kettle. The security footage shows the electric tea kettle in the kitchen, apparently turned on by the spirit. It shuts off and Sylvia enters the kitchen and asks why it put the kettle on.
Spirit in the kitchen, what are you trying to tell me? Why did you do that?
The spirit answers rudely in response by throwing a pot lid across the kitchen. Some viewers suggest to Sylvia to keep a detailed log of each of the paranormal events she experiences, including the date and time and her response to them. Others suggest having the house blessed to remove the entity. If you were in Sylvia's shoes, what would you do? I'd be looking to move as soon as possible. This Area 51 video appears to capture no less than 5 bright lights traveling in a tight cluster. It kind of looks like the government could be testing military-grade flares at first, until the lights mysteriously stop in midair, hover for a bit, and then move in the exact opposite direction. These sophisticated flight patterns seem to suggest that they are piloted by intelligent beings. At the 1 minute mark, all the lights grow intensely bright and almost meld into one solid form, at which point a smaller piece breaks off and moves upwards. This looks like no aircraft that has ever existed before, and as far as many are concerned, it can only be one of two options: a top secret government prototype, or else actual aliens.
This footage, published by Paranormal World in August of 2019, shows a scenic mountain and forest opposite an overpass. After completing a full 360 to take it all in, the camera falls to the cars whizzing past below before returning to the mountain. This time, the mountain isn't the only thing carving out the sky. A Godzilla-like creature peeks out from behind the mountain. At first, one might mistake it for the mountain itself, but it slowly begins to move, voiding that theory. While many in the comments say this is a good edit, some are more concerned by the man's reaction. YouTuber Dap writes, "If there is a Godzilla, you are running, not chewing gum." That's probably true, although other people note that the creature is friendly, so perhaps the cameraman had no need to fear him. Still, seeing a creature the size of a mountain would probably get your heart pumping, friendly or not.
This video, taken at the North Dallas High School in Texas by a YouTuber named Smart Dolphin, captures a very hard to find figure at the end. I've highlighted the possible ghost so that you can see it more easily. This is without a doubt the colorless outline of a human. You can see his feet shift a little bit as he changes his stance if you look closely enough. With this in mind, the question becomes whether or not this person was living when this video was recorded. I guess it wouldn't be too hard to make somebody look all gray like this with some decent editing equipment, but let me know if you think this is a genuine ghost or just a fake.
An urban exploration channel called Urbex with Taffy goes investigating an underground bunker when they start to feel incredibly watched for no reason at all. They pause at the entrance to a dark room and, night vision rolling, call out to any haunting the tunnels with them.
Okay, alright, so, is there anyone in here with us? Would you make a sound? Just make a noise?
In the doorway is a shadow person who is not Taffy nor his friend, Carl. As you can see both of their shadows, it's weird that a third shadow appears as soon as they ask for a sign, but this wouldn't be too hard to fake with a third person's help. The question is whether or not it was really the two of them down there in the creepy haunted tunnel. And that's something only Carl and Taffy will know for sure.
A YouTuber named Encounters26 is fishing late at night in Bishopville, Maryland, when he comes across something unnatural in the forest.
Do you see it where?
Whoa.
Holy.
A silent, hulking figure makes its way through the murky swampland, apparently trying to get away quickly without being noticed. Encounters 26 believes this to be some sort of lizard man creature, which would explain why the creature does not make any noise as it tries to escape the flashlight's glare. I was almost positive that this was just a person in a suit until it turns back to the camera. You can see some sort of sharp white scales coming out of its back, almost like a dinosaur, and its arms look way too skinny to be a person's.
Holy.
A TikToker named Sarimar Munez finds herself laid out across the floor in surprise at this ghost sighting, which she is about to point out in a moment. She is singing a musical when a small gray face pokes into the shot and then retreats. The way it moves on its way out looks better than most edited videos, so either she put a lot of effort into this one, or as much as I wish it wasn't, maybe it's real. Two unexplained videos have captured a strange sighting of a humanoid figure floating over Phoenix, Arizona. Anyone know what that is? Writes one of them in a Snapchat video posted on March of 2020. So far, no one has any idea. The uploader goes on to explain that they were in their backyard when a mysterious figure silently floated over them, an all-black outline with what they describe as wings in the middle. While I do see what he's talking about, I doubt they are wings because they are not moving. It looks more like a jetpack or something, and yet I don't see any exhaust, so it's probably not that either. An experimental drone or a weather balloon would be my next guess, and if it's not that, then maybe it's a kite shaped like a person. With that said, it's been over a year, and the strange sky sighting videos over Phoenix are still without explanation. The mystery is unsolved. What happens when your shop vandals turn out to be paranormal? This security footage was published in April of 2010 by Old Phantom 13. He writes, "We had been having problems with people breaking into and vandalizing our shop, or so we thought, so we set up several security cameras. This is what one of our cameras picked up. If you watch closely at the beginning, you'll be able to see what we believe is some type of spirit or ghost. The video shows lockers inside the shop slamming closed, one after another. Then repeated slamming noises are heard off screen. A wheelchair in the middle of the room rolls slowly from one side to the other. What do you think? Are these ghosts into vandalism? Or is this another video of strings, like some in the comments suggest? It certainly looks convincing when I look at it." Paranormal activity was recently caught on video by this family in Pakistan, but I'm not sure if this is a poltergeist or just them throwing things around, so help me decide. Most of the objects come from the corner of the screen and could have been easily thrown by someone off camera. I'm not sure how they made the table come back after it was thrown against the wall, but it doesn't look that heavy, so maybe it was on a wire. I guess we'll never know for sure. Smoke wafted through the Yellow Line train on January 12, 2015. While it filled the train, commuters waited over 35 minutes for help to escape. The cause is believed to have been an electrical issue in the tunnel. When the issue occurred, it forced commuters on the platform to evacuate. That's when train 302 pulled towards the platform and took off again. But it was so thick the train operator was blinded. He pulled to a stop in the tunnel. The train's fans were pulling smoke inside, and firefighters were only dispatched when they received a 911 call about 7 minutes later. Meanwhile, the passengers on the train could barely breathe and many got down on the floor. In the raw video of the train, you can see just how bad it is inside the wagon, and you can hear people cough. Well, most lie or squat on the floor.
Over the intercom, they are told to remain calm and not to open the doors. Some call 911 to describe where the train was located so that rescuers could be sent down. Out of the 380 people who were evacuated from the train, 86 were treated, 9 were treated outside the station, and 1 passed away. This clip is making waves in the Spanish YouTube community, and it's clear to see why. This associated image was posted in July of 2020 by YouTuber Curious Area. And at first, this footage seems like nothing more than your average nighttime drive. Spooky lights, empty streets, no one around. That is, until this creepy oblong figure emerges standing on the side of the road. As the car drives slowly past, the figure doesn't move from near the crosswalk. You can't make out its face or any details of its visage, but it does appear to be wearing a long robe. Would this get your heart pumping, or are your nerves made of steel? You expect to be entertained by Monday Night Football, not frightened, but some people were when they saw a groundskeeper vanish into thin air in the background of the news feed. In the footage, Jamie Carragher and Phil Neuville discuss the events of the night while presenting at Sky Sports Studio. Live on air behind them, the TV sets show a groundskeeper at the Stadium of Light seemingly preparing the grounds for the upcoming event or repairing them after the game. As he crosses the field in Sunderland, suddenly he simply vanishes. Those who spotted the figure were aghast. Was this a ghost caught in action on live TV? Some say it may just be overlapping feeds, but others believe what they saw was real paranormal activity. This paranormal investigation takes place in an abandoned building in Indonesia. I can't tell what is being said, but you don't need words to tell this person is being relentlessly stalked by something not of this world. First, they play some kind of song which I think is meant to summon spirits. A short while later, a shadow person peeks around the corner and appears where his thumb is. If somebody could please translate what is being said here, then maybe it could help us piece together what this video is all about. I don't think he noticed anything at first, but this is the exact moment he sees the spirit. Again, please translate if you can. And tell me if you think he sounds sincere or if he is acting.
Itu setengah bukannya. Gimana kalau coba?
The way he turns and bolts without saying a word is very realistic, so I'm inclined to believe this is not a joke. And when he looks again, the ghost is up way high in the left corner.
I think he is losing his mind at this point and he squats in the corner to hide.
He thinks he is safe, but the door opens and closes by itself and a strange mist floats up towards the knob. He runs away and stops to look around, panting, completely out of breath and scared senseless. This faint moan before the video ends makes me think he did not make it out alive. Folkloric Creature is insanely creepy. Published to YouTube by Romeo Candid in November of 2007, this clip claims to show a real maninagal. Some info on this mythical creature. The maninagal is a traditional and mythical Filipino creature that's likened to a vampire or a witch. The details of this horrible creature's prey are even freakier. It is said to prey on pregnant women, especially those who are sleeping. New lovers or newlyweds are also prime targets for the maninagal, which is said to have been abandoned at the altar. Now onto the clip. The video shows a group of people just hanging out in the dark, shining their flashlight everywhere. There's nothing for a while but darkness. That is, until everyone starts screaming as they see this ghastly female creature with black hair and greenish skin appear at a short distance. The creature turns to them as they cry out in horror. Many in the comments are rightly freaked out by this.
YouTuber Andrew Gibbons offers a first-hand account of the Maninago folktale, saying, "Well, one thing I know for sure that I heard from an elder is that it's an old folktale to keep kids out of the woods at nighttime." YouTuber ChowSice01 adds, "Some say that they heard it flap its wings while they're in their houses, but who knows, it might just be a bat." He also says that some truly believe that these creatures are real after watching this video. This is the story of the Cage of Saint Osyth, published on the website The Ghost Hunt UK in January of 2018. A writer and paranormal investigator by the name of Brad Mack gives a little background about himself and his family of dream chasers who love haunted locations, the supernatural, and investigating the lives of those who stick around after having long passed. According to Brad, he's seen some crazy things in his time as a paranormal investigator, but this piece of evidence is the most terrifying. During the Dark Ages, Essex was basically the Salem of the UK. Lots of so-called witchcraft and witch hysteria, resulting in spirits remaining there centuries later. For four centuries, the cage in question was locked up in a single building that had a separate cell for those who were considered witches. You can be sure it's left its mark. According to stories about the old place, one of the tenants who bought the place in the 19th century sold it just 2 weeks after buying it for a third of the initial cost, likely due to whatever he'd experienced inside the home. According to the current tenant, took his own life in the master bedroom after becoming a recluse. Even more chilling, there is an old mental asylum opposite the cage which is also reputably haunted, as well as a haunted two-door pub down the street. Now, to the events that were caught on camera on December 2nd, 2017. During the investigation of the cage, Brad's Mel meter, an EMF measurement tool, kept fluctuating a lot. To add to that, whispers and heavy footfalls were heard throughout the night, and lights flickered frequently. Brad also claims to have been pinched on the leg, and he managed to capture what he calls stick figures on camera. When he tried to touch one of the figures, it recoiled. But the thing that frightened him most was caught on iPhone footage from CCTV at around 3 a.m. This video shows the master bedroom, which Brad calls the most hostile room in the house, placing a camera and walkie-talkie in the bedroom. Brad and Dave watched from downstairs, along with flickering lights. Brad heard a growl and three bangs of a door. Then they called over the walkie-talkies, as they couldn't see one of the volunteers on camera. Another volunteer answered that she was right next to her, but the only thing they saw in her place was not Debbie. "This is Debbie. This is what they captured on film. Is this a trick of the light? Has Debbie been possessed by something evil? Or is this not Debbie at all, but rather the ghost of a witch?" Either way, based on the story of this place and the footage captured, it looks real to me. Have you ever watched a clip that terrified you so much that you just had to share it with a friend? That's definitely the case for this video, posted to YouTube by Mysterious Things in February of 2020. The footage purports to show an unknown flying object flying in broad daylight above Quebec City. From far away, the figure in the sky appears to be dressed in white and launching upward. Upon closer, unfocused, and wavering inspection, the unknown flying object does indeed look like a human figure dressed in white. At times, its clothing shines luminescent while the figure spins, launching into the sky. When the camera gets in closer and more focused, the figure looks even more dramatic. It appears to be on fire. If that's not in fact Iron Man, as YouTuber Graham Shearwood suggests in the comments, perhaps it could be a meteor headed towards Earth, while other commenters say this is impressive and looks legit. YouTuber Damian Torres is more skeptical, suggesting it looks like silver helium balloons with the sun reflecting off of it. What do you think? Is this just a mistaken balloon, or do you think this unknown flying object is worthy of some supernatural speculation? Whatever it is, it's terrifying. This one looks straight out of a horror movie. Posted by Wet Tent YT to the Chills Narrator subreddit, and originally published to YouTube in September of 2020, this is an urban exploring adventure turned into a nightmare. The uploader explains that this is a follow-up to a recent video he posted. He came across several tunnels after leaving an abandoned garage, and in these tunnels he encountered a figure he'd seen at the last location. These videos were filmed within hours of each other and showcase a strange person or figure that followed me while exploring. If you looked closely, it seemed to have an axe, and its eyes also looked like they were sort of glowing. In the video, after wandering down a tunnel, the uploader hears something. He sets his camera down on the ground in the tunnel facing the exit. That's when the aforementioned figure is captured, pounding on the roof of the tunnel with what appears to be an axe. Meanwhile, the uploader races down the adjacent tunnel, and when the Axeman leaves, retrieves his camera from the ground, and races back towards where the Axeman exited, shouting, "Who are you?" No response. He should probably be grateful about that. How would you feel if your CCTV camera caught this? Posted to the Ghosts subreddit by RelevantHole5903. This footage of a woman in white was caught on camera in the dark of night. It shows a ghostly figure in white crossing the grounds outside of a gated building with barbed wire fixed to the top. The stranger walks slowly in her flowing dress until she leaves the camera's sight. Some are suggesting this is a classic walk of shame, others think the Redditor lives next to some shady stuff, but some are sure it's the legendary La Llorona. If it is, stay clear of water, because the legend goes that she would take your life in the water. Redditor Blues Forever 67 writes, "This is one of those instances where I think, what if we see ghosts all the time, but they're so vivid that we just think they're people?" I have to agree with that statement. My mind has been blown by this footage. Thank you so much for getting me to 30,000 subscribers here on my Clips channel. If you want to support, please press that subscribe button. Let's get to 40,000 subscribers next. Thank you.